So Google Tasks has added a new ability that connects Google Documents with Google Tasks. I'm going to show you how it works in today's video. If you're new here to keep productive, please hit subscribe. It'd be amazing to have you here as a subscriber. Let's dive into this tutorial.
You have always been able to see this on the right hand side. Ever since they introduced Google Tasks, you've been able to add a task to the right hand side, but you've never really been able to connect anything on here and assign it to other people. This is a new feature that they've added more recently in Google Workspace accounts. I'll include some of the information about where they're placing this in the article below. However, I believe it's in a few places like Workspace basic accounts, I think, but I'll list it below so you know and whether it's applicable to you. So in Smart Canvas, which is the fairly new abilities, you can add things like building blocks, files and lists, etc., which they're continually looking to add to. But if you type in task, so you can see that the task is added and you can see that you can now add and connect a Google task, and it is the same thing. So if I type in, say, this is a meeting note, write report, and you can see that I've added the Steve to assign this, so you can add this to any of team members, and I could say tomorrow. So if I press assign as a task, you can now see that this is a task that lives within your Google document. And you can see here that you can update the task title to match the document if you wanted to. However, otherwise, this is a task assigned to Steve, which is perfect because I can now give him stuff to do inside of Google Documents. But it's helpful because he can tick this off and I can be able to collaborate with him after each of the meetings. And you can see who it's assigned by as well and even delete it too. The reason you would update the task title to match the document is the assignee will see the changes and I'll be able to relevantly see, okay, this is the editor review page and I'll be able to get that. Now over on this side, you will not be able to see it as a task that you have in your system. However, if I did go ahead and write myself a task, like reach out to Bob and go over here and assign it to myself and give it a date of on Monday, assign as a task, I should be able to now see this as part of a task. So you can start to see it pop up in the top right-hand corner. But what's nice is if I click into this, I can see the document it's related me to, and it's brought up my emoji now in this right-hand side. Now, if I want to, I can now open this up on the right-hand side to find the task, and it's a better way to connect everything together. So this is not only perfect for meeting notes, but it's perfect for a lot of collaboration that goes unmissed inside of your Google Drive account. The Smart Canvas is continually improving. They've more recently added better ways to improve the page setup. So you can go pageless now. And if I go and press OK, what happens is it's almost extensive, like Coda and, well, not like Notion does, but similar to how they do it in terms of that. And they're investing a lot more in connecting the experiences up. Now, we recently did a dummies guide to Google Keep, but you can basically create a note and connect it to your docs. So it'd be interesting to see how things are created later. You can also connect Calendar to your Drive now, which is a nice addition. So hopefully you found this new ability in Google Tasks to be helpful. Please do let me know what you think of it. And of course, Steve will be able to collaborate with this in real time and be able to tick this off, I'm sure. Thank you very much, folks, and I hope you found this video useful. Please do become a subscriber on Keep Productive today. It'd be great to have you here on this channel.